this is my new starter base design. I call it the Valkit, because you can tell it looks like a Valkit. And oh, if I don't go through the ground, help me. It has a basic airlock with a bed. It's meant for solo or duo, and if you come in, you've got three small boxes plus two large boxes that, with a little bit of difficulty, you can access. Oh, come on. I was doing that a minute ago. You can access it, I'm just not amazing at it. Two more big boxes down here, with two more small boxes, a barbecue for your food, and a workbench level 1. This base does not have a recycling, research table, but I mean, that's pretty easy. We've done outside, and at the start, you don't research that much. So, when you come in here, you've got an unlootable TC room, so even if they do destroy it, they'll have to go another 10 satchels to get through this wall, which I'm realizing now should be this way, so it's hard side, so it's harder to get through, obviously. You got your three furnaces down here with another sleeping bag and a campfire, and that's about it. Pretty simple to make. I'm pretty sure it's like 6k stone. Yeah, well, 6.5k stone, 1k wood, so that's pretty easy. It's like 3k each stone, 500 wood, and then you have this base if you put in geo, and obviously you have to collect it all of it. So, coming in for the doors, if you want a TC, it would be 4 satchels, 8 satchels. You could get the main loot. Well, you get loot. This, I would probably put your main loot in these, because most likely people go through the doors at the start. And this would be turned into 12 satchels, and you could obviously destroy it with one, but to get the TC room, that'll be another 10 satchels to get through the wall around it. So then, if you go through that way, it's actually going to cost you 22 satchels to get TC. The cheaper way would be if you come through the door, this wall here, and then you'd instantly have TC with 10 satchels, cutting it by 12. But you don't have access to any of the loot. You probably have access to this and that. You could obviously get in here pretty easily, but once you're here, it'll be another 4. So, to get all the loot and TC, cheapest way would be 14 satchels, and I would predict that they would go through the doors, which would cost them 22 satchels.
Starting off with a footprint, you want to build a square foundation, quite low to the ground, but not too low. If you build it too low, you won't be able to get these triangle foundations in. And you just put triangle foundations at either side, and a high triangle foundation. So this should be your footprint. 4 triangle foundations and 1 square foundation. And from here, you'd want to build walls all the way around. And then 2 doors here. Another wall here. Make sure, obviously, hard side facing out away. You don't want soft side facing out. And from here, just build half walls all around, like so. And this one, you want this one, change this to hard side facing this way, so it's harder to break in, because this is where your TC will be. Just push your TC down anywhere, doesn't really matter, as long as you can access it, which you will be able to do. And what's good about it is if someone comes and raids you, even if they break TC, unless they go through this wall or these walls, they won't be able to get the loot. They can maybe see the loot, but they won't be able to access it. So it's good, because they might not break TC, or they will, but they won't get the loot unless they waste so much sulfur, which won't be worth it near the start of a wipe. And you probably have a honeycomb by the time they get it. So then just build a triangle here, so that's extra storage. Just build roofs all along. Build, triangle here. You want a frame here for a double door. You also want a floor here, which could be annoying for sometimes. Got lucky. You want 3 furnaces to fit in here, which is usually a good number for a starter base. Gets really done. Hate pushing these though. You have to get like perfectly in the corner, or all three won't fit. Easier fit in. I'm just not good at doing all this, which is pretty annoying because we need perfect boxes as well later on. I would recommend this would be a solo duo, but if you want a third man, you can replace one of the boxes down here for a sleeping bag, and then build a box here, because there's a lot of storage, so you don't need all the storage. But I place your first sleeping bag here, and just like a second sleeping bag in the, what you might call it, airlock, which is not amazing, because you don't really want a sleeping bag in an airlock, but as I said, you can replace one of the boxes down here if you really want to, but I'll just put it in so I have more room. Just to help me, I'm going to build a foundation. So, you want it so you can't see the sleeping bag from the outside through the door. And obviously if someone's in the airlock, they can break this, but just try not to get deep on. From here, you probably want to put your double door in now. So let's go get it. I would recommend your double door facing this way, so it opens up this way. I just feel it'd be much easier than the other way, so it doesn't get in the way of everything. But in the end, it's up to you. And then get two small boxes and two large boxes. Jump up on this platform here, or this platform here. So you place one large box, like so. And then there's another large box. Place a small box beside the large box, and then just keep jumping until you get it in here, like so. You can also fit a campfire beside the first sleeping bag. That's a little bit of a light source if you need it, or just because it's extra 5 slots, which could be pretty good. From here, you'd want to add your loot room in here. So it doesn't have a recycling place, so you can't put it down on a recycling workbench, but you could obviously, if you really wanted the recycling workbench, you can customize this the way you wanted it, because you still got boxes up here. So you could stick a workbench and a work, what you call it, you could do the way I'd done it in the last one, with two large boxes, workbench one, barbecue, small box, and a small box. Or you could probably, if I go search up workbench, get the workbench, and get the recycle. Not recycling, research table. You could probably stick a research table against this wall. If I close the door. And then stick a, or you can stick this against any wall, I guess. This could also help you jump up for here. I mean, I would recommend probably doing it the two boxes, but I guess you could actually fit a large box in there, and then still get a large box in here. So I guess you might still have the same amount of storage if I'm thinking about this. Maybe if we get a couple of these, one of these. I'm not doing this perfectly. Maybe if I quickly get this again. So you can customize this the way you want to. I didn't put a lot of thought into it, but I thought the first design was alright, so I just kind of left it. But I know people obviously want a research table in their base because it's useful. You don't really want to do your research in outside that much, just in case someone jumps up on you while you're outside. You can't fit that in there, but you can fit a box in there. You might be able to fit two small boxes or one small box if I try and fix this bit. Pressing large boxes, you have to get flush. Yes. Well, I might be able to squeeze one in there. Nah, definitely not. You might be able to put a campfire on there. Roll to get you that extra 5 slots plus a light source if needed. But you can't. Or I can't. Someone will probably do this better. So with the other design, it's a lot easier to run across, and you have two benches, you got two of these, so you're missing storage by a barbecue, but then you've got your research table. So I guess it works up for it. I guess it's up to you. The other one is two large boxes like this, workbench here, a barbecue and workbench in the corner with a small box here, barbecue and a small box here. I'm actually going to keep it with this. I think this would be more useful for other people because of the recycling. And if you need another sleeping bag, just take out this large box and plop a sleeping bag down there, because some people want third man, or if you want to get rid of your sleeping bag in the airlock, that's completely fine. To press these ones, these are so much more annoying even. I'd actually probably press it before you press this doorway, or press it before you press this doorway, so you can jump up on top and then equip it down too. But I'm just gonna leave it without. I don't want it to be too crowded because these are more of drop boxes, so I want these to be easier accessed. So if you came in, you can just dump loot. I would probably dump loot in this one more than these ones, and then sort this one out. But I guess it's up to you in the end. I need to stick another door on. Also put code locks on them as well, just so they're harder to raid. And then from this side you can access two. You won't be able to access this one though, because you'll be putting another small box right in between here, which you can do like that. So then you've got all three. So then you can someone can access two large boxes on that side, and someone can access two large boxes on this side. You can access all this. If someone was down here, they can still access this large box, the small box, this large box, this large box, and that small box. So there's not a lot of them, but you can access multiple chests for multiple people at the same time. And that's about it. And as I said before, if someone was to come in with satchels, I would see them come in at the door, because that's what most people do at the start of wipes. They go through the door because it's usually cheaper. But to get all loot, it would be 4-8 satchels, and then it'd be in this room, which would be decent loot, but I would probably keep your main loot, which you're not going to have much of, in these boxes. And yeah, that'll be 12 satchels to get to these boxes. And then if they want TC loot, that'll be another 10 satchels to get to here, or one satchel to break it, but they won't be able to get the loot. So to get all everything, this whole base would be from doors, it would cost you 22 satchels, and could put the raid up a little bit if you change this double door to a garage door. That'll put it up to, that's another 10 satchels with a garage door. So that'd be 10, 20, 22, 24, 28 satchels to get all loot. But obviously, if you came in from the wall, it would be cheapest going from this wall here, because you get straight TC, but you wouldn't get any of the loot. So, I mean, I'd rather go for loot than TC loot, depending. Because not many people have that much sulfur to start wipes, so I don't see TC's being stacked with sulfur. Yeah, I suppose.